The Data Entry Toolkit has been designed to centralize and provide a mechanism for valid and streamlined data entry. The pick lists form the basis of the data entry tools, enabling the user to create either textural or spatial style libraries for the entry of valid and consistent data. Let's get started. Firstly, we need to open up a MapInfo dataset. In this case, it's a geological dataset. What you will see here is a series of polygons which are color attributed, either by color or pattern, and there will be textural attributes laying underneath those polygons, as we can see as we hover the mouse over. When creating a pick list, you'll be able to extract the individual colors and textural attributes. To create a pick list, you will need to navigate to the Discover tab. On the end of the Discover tab is the Data Entry Toolkit. The Pick List Manager is located under the Setup drop-down. Okay, let's have a look at what a pick list is. A pick list can be anything from a point data set, a structural data set, a line data set, a polygon, and also textural. Pick lists are used for validating data, for entering consistent data, amongst other things. If we have a look at what a pick list is, this is a point data set, and we've got a series of codes, a series of styles, and then we can see over to the right we've got color attributes, size attributes, fonts, rotations, etc. This can be used in a drop-down or as a library table for the consistent entry of data. In this tutorial, we're going to concentrate on this Mount Isa data set. Under this configure drop-down are numerous options for managing your pick lists and your object styles. Create new pick list. This option enables you to create a blank new pick list which you can populate data. Delete an existing pick list. Save modifications or save a pick list. Rename a pick list, so you can see the naming convention there and the description. Append a pick list. You can append one pick list to another pick list. In this instance, we're going to import a pick list from an existing MapInfo dataset. On the Import Pick List dialog, you can see here there are numerous options for creating a pick list, from color maps, geostyles, legends, MapInfo professional tables, amongst other things. As the Mount Isa table is a MapInfo professional dataset, we leave the option checked, click OK. As the Mount Isa geological dataset is already open, it is available in the drop-down here. If you wanted to open the table, simply click on the folder button to the right. Now what we need to do is select the field which the colors or patterns have been attributed to. In this instance, it's the unit name. Now we need to give the pick list a name and also a description. Click OK. This particular data set has about 10,000 different polygons with about 40 or so different styles. Now, if you have a particular data set where there is two different color schemes for the one attribute, you will receive warnings like this. In this instance, I just click OK. It will pick the first color it came across. I'll scroll through the pick list manager here, and as we can see, we've got 43 unique styles with 43 unique codes and also patterns or colors. I will now show you how to manage your pick list. Firstly, when a pick list is created, you'll see that it's got a suffix of regions. This is because it's come from a region data set. To modify the name, click the Configure button and navigate to rename pick list and description. Simply delete this suffix, and if you wish, you can modify the pick list description. Click OK. Within a pick list, you have numerous styles that we can modify. To modify a particular record, what you need to do is highlight which one you want to modify. To modify a record, left click, you'll see the rename style dialog appear. To modify a style, click again. We can change patterns, we can change colors. If we scroll to the right here, you'll see things like border width, border styles, comments, etc. Another way of modifying the pick list is to use the buttons located at the bottom of the styles group. To add a new style, click the Add Style button. To delete a style, click the Delete Style button. To rename a style, click the Rename Style. And to modify the colors or patterns, as seen before, click the Edit Style button. Each of these records can be moved up or down to resort the pick list. Once you are happy with the current pick list style, click the Save button. Now you're ready to use your pick list. Thank you for watching this tutorial.